Well, Australia is facing a perfect storm of supply chain issues, which could, spell bad news for Christmas presents.
Well, that is not good news, but don't fear the Grinch just yet. There are ways to ensure you get exactly what you need. Today, reporter Bethan Yeoman investigates.
Remember sticking airmail on your postcards? Air freight has always been an expensive way to get things from A to B, but never more than now.
One thing that's a bit of a misnomer is that air freight comes in freight planes, and a large proportion of that air freight actually comes in the belly of passenger planes, and those passenger planes haven't been flying due to COVID.
Plan B is putting that stock on ships, but that hasn't been smooth sailing either. Clogged ports in China are causing a shipping backlog, and demand isn't slowing.
We've had, you know, close to 10 years of advancement in online in the space of close to 2 years.
Shipping lines are making decisions based on volume, not need, and Australia just can't compete. Travis Erridge is the CEO of TMX, APAC's leading supply chain consultancy, working for the likes of Coles, Bunnings and Kmart.
They've typically been holding higher inventory levels than what they traditionally would to cover for some of the delays that are expected. But inevitably, there's going to be people that haven't planned or didn't have the infrastructure to plan that are going to be caught short with some of the things that are going on.
It's not what retailers want to hear in the lead up to the festive season.
Put it in perspective, last year, Black Friday and Cyber Monday, we had 20% of sales being online. This year it's tipped to be close to 100%, and we're talking about $18 billion worth of sales.
It may sound early for Christmas, but typically supply chains really start to ramp up from the back end of August. Products usually take up to 6 weeks to arrive, but that lead time is now ballooning to 15 weeks in some cases.
The safest option is buying local. Amazon Australia is preparing for its biggest festive season yet, hiring an extra 1,000 workers to help pick, pack and ship orders.
We've got around about 125 million products in our catalogue, but the really good thing is that we've got, you know, Amazon Local Store, and that allows 10,000 Australian sellers to be able to sell on Amazon, and those sellers were not impacted by overseas shipping constraints.
Oz Post has been chartering its own flights to make up for the loss of domestic routes.
Normally we'd have about 50 Qantas flights a day between Sydney and Melbourne. We were able to pop our freight on and our Express Post parcels. That's currently one flight a day.
Quite the hurdle when you consider 10 million parcels are currently being delivered every single week.
Last December it was 52 million parcels. We're waiting with bated breath, but we think it's going to get even bigger. And each year we see it start earlier and earlier.
The overarching message is simple. Don't leave your Christmas shopping to the last minute.
People need to get out there as soon as they possibly can and start buying in stores or ordering online, but have a very clear look at what the disclaimers are online in terms of delays to make sure it is available when you need it.
Go.
Worth noting, those delays aren't going to affect Santa.
No, Santa will be
on a special day. Mm. Yeah.